the president today at the CDC. We played that clip talking, for instance, about the cruise ship not wanting the passengers to come to, into the actual physical United States because then they'd be counted in statistics. What are you hearing from folks in the administration, folks around the president, about that visit, about what he's trying to communicate here and what he actually is communicating here?
Well, none of what he communicated is what anyone in the administration has been trying to communicate. And you pointed out the example of that contrast between what the vice president was saying about the testing kits and what the president is saying about the testing kits. I mean, we see this time and time again where you have people in the administration, people in the White House working on a well-crafted message that is then completely blown up by the president. I mean, it started very early in the day today where the White House said, you know, the president wasn't going to be going to the CDC. They didn't say why. And then the president tells reporters it was because there was someone at the CDC that they thought had coronavirus. And it turns out that test was negative. And so now he's going to go, but basically contradicting what his own staff had said earlier in the day. And of course, I think one of the most striking things he said out of that mini press conference he did with reporters was, as you pointed out, about this, the number of passengers on the cruise ship. You know, the administration is trying to take the posture that they're not making decisions for political reasons, for optic reasons. You know, they see that narrative in the media and they push back about it. And then the president acknowledges, basically saying the quiet part out loud, that he's making a decision about what happens with these cruise passengers based on how the numbers look. And then he throws in this caveat about how he'll let other people make that decision, but it's his clear preference that he does not want these cruise passengers brought back into the U.S. because of what they would do to the statistics. So clearly him having a political, optical calculus in that decision, which is something his allies have been trying to counteract.
Lonnie, we mentioned you have a background with HHS. I wonder what goes through your mind when you see those two statements we played there from the president on the issue of testing and from the vice president sending two seemingly contradictory messages. What is the impact of that kind of messaging?
Well, I think, you know, at a time when you have the American people on edge, at a time when people want information, obviously information is power in this case, it's really important that the government speak with one voice. It is a whole of government response. It is something that this administration, I know, has been working hard to coordinate. But the challenge is, you know, when you look at pandemic planning, when you look at this is the way this has been done before, the emphasis has always been on can government speak with a single voice about what the current situation is, what the upcoming situation will be, and what the government is doing to respond. So it does create a challenge, I think, both for the administration, but also for the American people in terms of the information they're hearing and trying to figure out from what sources they should be acquiring that information and the accuracy of that information being called into question.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.